we're celebrating Black History or Black Heritage Month, and we have one of the leading authorities on African American and African flute music in the whole country with us. And I would like to introduce to you Dr. Wendy Hymes, Onovwerosuoke.
Pleasure to be here tonight. Thank you, Martin Arts, for having me. Thank you, Marie, for also having me at your poem concert series. So, yes, as Marie said, we're going to be playing some composers you maybe haven't heard before, and that's a good thing, right? So there is actually classical music based on traditions from every continent in the world. Well, maybe not Antarctica. So we don't really have the opportunity to get to know all of these different composers, but they're out there. So tonight, you have the opportunity to learn and hear some amazing new composers that I hope you will enjoy as much as I do, since taking the time to acquaint myself with them and make them my friends. It's a process. It's a process. So we're going to start out, the first piece of the program is by Valerie Coleman, a very wonderful African-American composer. She is also an accomplished flutist, which makes it wonderful when the composer knows your instrument. And she has composed a tour de force for the flute. It was for a competition for the National Flute Association High School Soloist in 2018, so you can know it is putting the flutist through his or her pieces. She's also composed a piece that is an ode to the world's musical styles. Fanny Imen is Haitian Creole for human family, and it comes from, the human family is the title of a very famous poem by Maya Angelou, and you can read the poem, it's very beautiful. So within the way she wants us to think about the world and all its beautiful peoples is she incorporates musical styles from many different traditions. There's a Middle Eastern caravan in here. There's some Spanish flamenco music in here. There's an African thumb piano called the kalimba in here. How many of you have seen the thumb piano before? There we go, okay, you're in the know. And there's actually, I get to imitate a djembe drum, which is super cool. I also get to do some singing and playing, which you're going to hear, you'll know it, and some flutter tom. So really hope you enjoy finding that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next piece on our program is by Fred Onovwerosuoke. Okay, repeat after me. There'll be a quiz at the end. You should know that. No, I'm just kidding. So I got to meet Fred Onovwerosuoke when I was a student of Marie's at Principia College a long time ago. So Fred is an amazing composer. I'm not biased, of course. I might be a little biased. He's my husband and partner. So he is born in Ghana, of Nigerian parents, and he traveled all over the African continent, over 30 countries, studying the native music traditions. And you can hear a lot of these traditions in his beautiful compositions. So today we're going to play two of his pieces. We're going to just play Pende, which is a lullaby from Central Africa, and we're also going to play Nankansu, which is inspired by the actual healing dances of the forest peoples, or sometimes referred to as the Pygmies. So enjoy. Thank you.
Antarctic index because my arm is on fire. I'm going to cool off. Anybody who's ever tried to do that on the piano, you'll know you can sympathize.
So while the screen comes down, we'll just say a little bit about this piece. Everything's in the program notes, but I'd love to tell you a little bit extra, right? So I'm not on soprano flute anymore. Oh, are there some flute players out there? Can you see someone shaking your head? All right. I'm on the alto flute now, and the alto flute is really important for creating the magical feeling for this composer's piece. So I put this piece on the program because I know Marie and Bill have been to Antarctica on multiple occasions, and I thought they would love this piece. The piece is a beautiful piece, and it's by another flutist composer, Elizabeth Brown, and she is also an accomplished shakuhachi player. Though some of you know shakuhachi, it's a Japanese flute, and it is similar, maybe in timbre, only it's made from bamboo, but it is lower pitched. So the alto flute really is not a surprise that she has used this for this piece. So you will hear some really interesting sounds along with a recorded soundtrack that is from the composer. I will be playing with this recorded soundtrack to create the magic of Antarctica. The images you're going to see behind me are different photos, some of which from Marie and Bill's trip, and some collected from free internet sources with beautiful pictures. Marie, would you like to say a few words about Antarctica since you've been there?
Yeah, it was about a year ago we left for Antarctica, and for me it was my second trip, and my husband was not on this trip. But the pictures that you'll see, some of them are very familiar to me because I took them with my cell phone. The first time I went, I took a very fancy camera and all of that and came back and realized, wow, the cell phone pictures came out just as well. So in any case, a lot of them are like the leopard seal, and you'll see a fluke of a whale, and you'll see in these incredible magical ice shapes, especially the ones with the aquamarine color. Those are from our trip when we were on a little zodiac floating around with the whales and all the other wonderful creatures. And when we came back from Antarctica, before we left, they said, please go back and do at least one thing to help our planet, because our penguins are dying out because they don't have the right food, and the Gentoo penguins cannot adapt to other food sources, so they've been dying out at a very high rate. So I thought, what one thing can I do? I don't take any plastic bags from a grocery store anymore. I learned my lesson by being there and watching that. We can all do one thing, at least one thing, to help save our planet, the wildlife, the natural beauty, and our well-being for all of us. Thank you, Wendy, for sharing this incredibly beautiful, magical piece.
Thank you.
incredible. What a phenomenal piece to go along with those images. And let me know if you want to go again. I'm ready to go. I've got my bags packed. So just let me know and I'll be right with you.
And do we have a speaker now?
Is she here?
She is.
Oh, she's here. I didn't see you come in.
Yes.
I would like to introduce our own Eula Clark, who's going to say just a few words about Black History, Black Heritage Month. We are so glad that Eula Clark is with us today, one of our Stewart commissioners.
Going. And when I think of Black History Month, and I think of the beginning of this year, and all the things that have happened, and how Dr. King, when we celebrate his holiday coming up on the 16th, how he started, but it always was in harmony, working hard to continue. And he believed in a dream. And now it seems like we're in a dreamlike place. Listen to this music. Let us keep good, positive things in our heart as we look at what our country has gone to, as we look at the things that are facing our country. Let us know that behind it all is faith. Dr. King leaned on faith, and he leaned on having strength from an inner, real inner strength. And I think having this music today, this concert series, the things that have happened, that it really is going to give us strength to continue to move on and to do glorious things. So thank you, Wendy. Thank you, Marie, for putting this on. And let us remember that Dr. King had a dream. Let us continue to dream and use this music piece to help get our dreams really in our hearts. And remember that we too can make a difference. And having the environmental piece, yes, we can make a difference with not one plastic bag. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Eula. Thank you for coming to join us.
So now we go back to a much warmer place, back to Ghana. For the next piece is by Johann Sebastian. John Hansen, Kwabena Nketia. Just comes out. So Nketia is from Ghana. He is the most prominent African musicologist. So now you learn something else. If someone asks you who's a composer from Africa and musicologist, just say Nketia. You'll look really smart. And so, much like Fred, he traveled the African continent documenting and collecting a lot of information about the native African cultural music traditions. And he wrote the book on the subject called The Music of Africa. You can Google it, you can buy it. And it is a stunning book that is still used by ethnomusicology programs and students around the world. So he also composed, no one really knew this until rather recently, he gave a lot of his compositions to Fred to share and to publish. They were unpublished. Republic Suite was written by Nketia to celebrate Ghana's independence in 1960. So it was premiered on Republic Day on July 1st, 1960, with Ghana's first president in attendance and a composer at the piano. So for Kwame Nkrumah, you might know that name, was Ghana's first president. So each movement portrays an aspect of Ghana's independence. We're going to do movement 2 and movement 5. Movement 2 is based on a popular highlight tune. People just taking to the streets, hey! Just imagine that. And then movement 5 is to their ears, it's just, that's natural, right? Yeah. So it's based on the Evan peoples and their amazingly intricate rhythmic dances. So we're going to want to demonstrate the bell pattern that's in movement five. Thank you.
So thank you very much for coming today. It's been a pleasure.